Hello dear students, welcome to MSBT online learning platform. We bring you the most relevant content in a most attractive digital format. Myself, Hastimal Kumawat, lecturer in Civil Engineering Department, Government Polytechnic, Yavatmal. In this session, we are going to cover UO2F, that is to calculate control levels for the given reservoir from the given data, which covers topic 2.6, control levels in reservoir. Topic 2.7, simple numerical problems on fixing control levels. This we're going to see in part 1 and part 2 videos. So the learning objective of today's session, to understand the various levels and storage zones in reservoir, to calculate control levels for the given reservoir from the given data. So to achieve this objective, here is the content. First one is the concept map. Key definitions, control levels in dam, different storages in reservoir, information required for fixing the various levels, criteria for fixing various levels, examples in real life. Let us start with the concept map. Calculate or fix control levels in reservoir. This is our aim. Then to achieve this aim, there will be a new concept, that is control levels in reservoirs. So these are the levels. Then another concept, that is different storages in reservoir. These are the storages. Then we will see the information required to fix the control levels. Then criteria for fixing the various levels. And after this, we will solve the numericals which will achieve our objective, that is calculation or fixing the various levels in the dams. So let us start with the key definitions or important definitions. First one is the freeboard. It is the vertical margin kept between top bund level and high flood level. It is the margin kept as a measure of safety so that the waveform should not cross the top of the dam. Another definition, that is flood lip. It is the vertical distance between full reservoir level and high flood level. This portion is provided to take care of excess amount of water entering into the reservoir during the floods. Let us see the control levels in dams. So here you are able to see the cross section of a dam, and behind this there will be a reservoir pool, and these are the levels in the dam and these are the storages. So let us see these are what are the levels. TBL, that is top bund level. So top bund level is the reduced level of dam which depends on the storage capacity, flood lift and freeboard of the dam. The height of the dam at any section is the difference between top bund level and ground level. So here you can see the top bund level of the dam. Another is HFL, MWL, MRL. Maximum water level, maximum reservoir level, or the high flood level. So it is the maximum reduced level up to which water can rise in the reservoir. It depends on flood lift and full tank level. So here you can see the high flood level of the dam. Another is FTL or FRL, the full tank level or the full reservoir level. The water in reservoir is stored up to a level known as FTL or FRL. Usually the crest of the spillway is kept at this level. So here you can see the full tank level of the dam. Another is LWL, DSL, LSL. Lowest water level, dead storage level, lowest sea level. So it is the lowest reduced level of water surface in the reservoir. If water goes below lowest water level, then water cannot be drawn out of the reservoir. So here you can able to see the DSL of the reservoir. So this is all about the control levels in dam. Now let's see the different storages in the reservoir. First one is dead storage. So the dead storage below lowest sea level cannot be used, and hence it is called as dead storage. The water in this region is mostly mixed with the silt. That's why it is of no use. So here you can able to see the dead storage of the reservoir. Another thing is live storage. So the storage between BSL and the FTL is known as live storage. So here you can see the live storage in the reservoir. Generally, the live storage is calculated as effective crop water requirement plus tank losses plus carryover allowance. And by adding these two storages, you will get the gross storage. So the gross storage is given as it is the storage at full tank level in the reservoir. This is how these storages are supposed to be formed in the any of the reservoir or any of the tank. Now let us see the information required for fixing the control levels. So very first, that is catchment area, how much area to be bringing the amount of water. So that area is needed. Then type of catchment, fan shape, fern shape, or any other catchment is there. Then rainfall data. Then you require the command area, how much area to be irrigated, that area is needed. Then proposed crop pattern is needed. Delta, duty, transit losses and intensities are needed. Again, the area capacity curve you required. Then rate of silting, how much rate will be there of silting. Then how much is the life of reservoir, 100 year, 150 year, 200 years. Then rate and gradient of canal system. Last one is the reservoir losses. So this much information is required to design or to fix the control levels in the dams. Then now let us see the criteria for fixing the various level. So to fix LSL, LWL, DSL, it should be highest of the following. So here are the criteria. Reduced level corresponding to silt storage capacity will be given as rate of silting multiplied by catchment area multiplied by life of dam. So generally, the rate of silting will be taken as 200 to 500 meter cube per kilometer square per year. Another criteria is reduced level corresponding to 10% of gross storage or crop water requirement. And third one is reduced level of bed of canal at head plus full supply depth in canal. So among these three criteria, you have to choose the highest one. Another criteria, that is for fixing the high flood level, full reservoir level and top bund level. So the full reservoir level should be fixed at gross storage, and the gross storage will be taken as lesser of demand and supply. Suppose the demand is 4000 meter cube and the supply is 5000 meter cube, then you have to choose the lesser one, that is demand 4000 meter cube. From this FRL, you are supposed to calculate the high flood level, which is given as HFL is equals to FRL plus flood lift. And this flood lift is assumed between 2 to 3 meter. Then from this HFL, you are supposed to find out the top bund level will be given as HFL plus freeboard. And the freeboard will be assumed depending upon the height of the dam. So friends, in part 1 video, this much is okay. In part 2 video, we will solve the numericals which is based on these criteria. Thank you. Thank you very much.